Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Mahantesh. I'm Associate Publisher and Director Community with 9.9 Group. Welcome to the Entity NetMagic and Google Cloud webinar titled The Future of Work, Digital Workspace and VDI. Just a few months back, we were all looking forward to a new decade of growth, and the talk was about ramping up technology to enable enterprises. Invest, invest, invest. The pandemic endangered crisis has pushed the pause button, and the CIOs face a new challenge. How to do more with less? The primary concern for business is reducing operating cost while increasing productivity and profitability. And also, CIO has to ensure that the new demands arising out of the necessity to continue with remote working do not lead to higher cost, complexities, and headaches. But at the same time, there cannot be any compromise on performance or security. As the primary actors during the pandemic crisis, the tech fraternity enabled virtual workforces, there was no time to thoughtfully plan an operating model or carefully implement it to achieve maximum value, productive workers, while mitigating business risk. For an interim time period, a hastily put together the work from home infrastructure could work. But in the long term, this stopgap arrangement has potential pitfalls that could have serious implications for the enterprise. We know that, and it worries us. Time to think lean, think nimble, think simple, and above all, think secure. Here is where desktop as a service enters, but let's have that to our experts to take forward. Just before I invite our speaker, let's have a look at the list of people who have answered the quiz correctly and won themselves a rupees 500 gift voucher. Vivek, can we have the list, please? Congratulations to all the winners. The gift voucher will be emailed to you shortly. With that, now I invite our expert from Entity NetMagic, Makarduaj Tambade, Assistant General Manager, Products and Services at Entity NetMagic, leading IT service and technology solutions provider in India. Makar has a strong background in engineering and product management. He has helped many organizations of all sizes to drive digital transformation, cloud adoption journey. In today's session, he'll be taking us through digital workspace and VDI, which is future of work, how the business continuity can be achieved during this pandemic time with VDI. Just a reminder, if you have a question during the presentation, please post it in the chat box on your screen. The questions will be taken up by the speakers at the end of the webinar. Over to you, Makar.
Thank you. Thank you for that introduction. Hello. Good afternoon, everyone. Welcome to this session. Okay, as we all know that, okay, the pandemic has really impacted all our businesses, okay, during this uniquely challenging environment. And we need to see how we can make the businesses more resilient during this pandemic actual. And this is actual a rapidly changing COVID picture means our one false move can impact seriously on our corporate performance as well as the company value. During this time, when things are really turning around rapidly, every organization's first priority is to stabilize the business. So that is the most topmost priority action item for all the CIOs at present. And how we are going to achieve that? By taking the realistic view on the current options, identify the path that maximizes the value. Recently, one of the Gartner's business continuity survey shows that only 12% of organizations are highly prepared for the COVID-19 situations. That's a shocking number, because if we see, it also shows that many of the organizations approach the risk management in an outdated or inefficient manner. The way we are preparing ourselves, or the way risk management we are doing during this pandemic, most of the organizations are not really approaching it at the right manner, okay? And we know that we need to act now in order to save the businesses, in order to respond to this pandemic and ensure that the business continuity is in place actually. So after that actual, we also need to ensure that how the risk is addressed actual, even though if you, those only 12%, and what about the remaining organizations? So those remaining organizations are struggling, either they are preparing for remote work environment creation kind of stuff, they are managing their existing risk, and they are in different actual stages at present actual. But at this moment, what we need is a solid plan for the business continuity, ensure that the business operations are running smoothly without any impact. And okay, during the previous few weeks, we also know that okay, the only mean is the work from home. Enable our employees to work from home, ensure that the business operations are continue. There is no any impact of that on the businesses. Okay, and this is immediate step. So some of the organizations have already taken those steps. Some of the organizations have really not taken those steps, and they are evaluating the multiple options. Choice is very simple. Either we need to adapt, or either we need to wait for the situation, or we need to ignore. Ultimately, the first choice where we need to mitigate these change challenges and enable our workforce to work remotely or work anywhere actual to ensure that the collaboration is at place and business is continued. So when we say we need to enable our workforce or connect co-worker from okay diverse locations or from different locations, we need to ensure that we have right collaboration tools at the place, right system is at the place to ensure that they are working from home. Again, working from home does not come with only a technological challenges. There are individual personal level challenges as well. Like if someone is working from home, especially in the country like India, it is very easy for someone to unplug after working hours. Sometimes people feel loneliness. Sometimes collaboration is a challenge actually, because everyone will have different priorities. And if we do have workforce or the clients or our other members who is working in different time zone, then those kind of issues are also actually very critical, and employee need to stay motivated. And ultimately, on top of that, the country like India, where we have internet penetration or constant connectivity, is actually a challenge beyond metro if we see a tier 2 and tier 3 kind of cities. But if you see at high level, what is the actual requirement of the employees to work from home during this kind of situation, or even beyond the pandemic as well? So the immediate action required, or the immediate requirement, is we need a secure devices. So like in order to enable the workforce fully productive, okay, and for the remote workforce, what we need or what organizations need to make working from like the user experience has to be a seamless. So when we are providing a device, or when the employee is using a device at the home, then that the application access has to be a very secure. Then organization also need to ensure that how do we have a policies in place, like do we have a zero trust kind of strategy, or organization is really depend on the network provider, and then even for security also they are depend on their network provider as well. So we need to see what kind of strategy we have when the employees are bringing in their own devices. Like, does our organization ready for allowing BYOD kind of options? And then on top of that, do we really have, or does the organization really have control on the application level rather than the traditional network actually? So we need to see all those aspects as well. And we also need to see that if employees are accessing the application, their user experience should be really good. And on top of that, the company data should be secured when the data is actual in the transit, and when the data is stored actually. So data security is important at both the aspects actually, when the data is in transit as well as when the data is actually stored in the central server. If we see a digital workspaces or the workspaces implementation or VDI solutions implemented by the organizations at present, we have a very traditional way actually. And if we see a traditional way where we establish actual, like we take care, or the customer or the organization need to take care of all these aspects actually. So right away, from power, cabling, storage, operating system, then we need to see okay, we need to plan the capacity for VDI kind of environment, like how many users are going to use that. Accordingly, we do the planning. Accordingly, we do the hardware actual ordering. And then sometimes the remote desktop implementation on-prem or VDI kind of implementations on-prem, it takes sometimes few weeks to few months actually. Even we saw that even for on-premise virtual desktop or the virtualization kind of solutions is also available, where we can leverage the virtualization for on-prem. And using virtualization, hypervisor and connection broker, we can implement the VDI solution for the branch or the on-prem instead of on the cloud. And we can implement the VDI. If we see all the VDI kind of solutions, which enables employee to work from home, most of them will have the nomenclature like either it will be an app streaming kind of solution, or it will be a desktop as a service to the remote employees, or under platform it can be an entire workstation where which the employee is using remotely, securely from anywhere actually, literally. But if we see those solutions, the major challenge comes actually if we are implementing those solutions on the prem, then the problem is we need to manage the complexity. As I mentioned that, okay, we need to plan the capacity. For example, we have 1,000 users or 1,000 user organization, and we are planning for, let's say, a 500 user capacity, then there is right away a capex in place actually. For on-prem deployment, we need to invest the entire capex. We need to put entire capex well in advance. Okay, before we start the consumption, we need to plan the capacity, and then capacity will get utilized over the couple of months or couple of year actually. Then again, the major challenges will be, okay, we need a skilled manpower to deploy a VDI kind of actual deployment on-prem. We need to plan for the hardware capacity, storage capacity. There again, SAN storage kind of solutions, which is costly in the nature. We need to do all that aspect. We need to do the project management activities. We need to set up the IT in-house team for the support for 24/7. So all those challenges, okay, it comes with the on-prem solutions. And even on top of that, if we see or if we identify ourselves in a COVID-19 kind of situation, then our all the infrastructure which we have deployed on-prem suddenly becomes inadequate in terms of capacity. Like we know that over past few weeks, every organization or few of the organization might have a VDI kind of deployment, okay, that is planned for X number of users. And because of this current pandemic, almost all the members or almost all the employees are forced to work from home, except those who got the special permissions, and those comes under the emergency services. Again, for those organizations also, only a limited staff, like 5 or 10% staff, will be only allowed under circumstances to go to the office and ensure that the business is continued, like clients like banking or even few other sectors like internet service providers, data center providers, and few more fields like manufacturing units and all those. But if we see the capacity, now the sudden challenge is we have a limited capacity plant. All the users or there is a huge sudden demand where we are forcing all the employees to work from home, and the existing infrastructure is not adequate. Now, in order to increase the capacity, in order to augment the capacity, again, we need to replan the hardware, existing storage capability, and those kind of current on-prem actual VDI deployments now suddenly becomes a problem. And we need a solution actual, which is there in the cloud or which addresses the main challenges. Firstly, around the TCO, total cost of like ownership, how the total cost of ownership can be minimized, how the user experience is seamless, and if there is a sudden capacity requirement like 2x times, 4x times, or even 10x times, the system should be able to cater that requirement. So from that background actual, Netmagic, and Google, we are proposing a solution which is a VDI solution. Actually, it's a VDI on the GCP cloud solution, which addresses all the major concerns around the on-prem VDI solution. The most major nomenclature is around, or it solves all the concerns or all the requirements, which is maybe around, it can be app streaming, desktop as a service, or platform as a service. On top of that, there is a choice where customer don't need to worry about managed service as well, because it comes with the default managed service offering for the workload which is there in GCP, including the VDI platform. So this is how we are proposing. In coming few slides, Pritham will help us to understand how the VDI solution has designed with the Google Cloud, how it is solving the challenges around the existing situation, how we can spin up the users, how we can meet the demand requirement, how the solution is helping along the TCO and all that aspect. I just would like to pause here because we have one full question coming in. And then subsequently, I will hand it over this to Pritham for show us on the VDI capabilities with the Google Cloud.
Thank you, Makar. We will take up all your questions post the second presentation. Delegates, please send in your queries on chat. We will now be taking the first poll on how prepared is your organization for business continuity during this pandemic. While everybody is taking the poll, I would now like to invite our next expert, Pritham Sahu, Partner Engineer, Google Cloud. Pritham has 13 years of IT industry experience with specialization on cloud and pre-sales experience in various geographies and market segments. He will take us through GCP and how it ties up with remote working. Over to you, Pritham.
Thanks, Montes. Hopefully you guys can see my screen.
Yes.
Okay. Thanks, Makar, for setting the context in. And guys, if you can go on mute, it's echoing. Thank you, everyone. So really super excited to be part of this webinar series. And thanks, Makar, for setting the context in. So as you know, like the VDI as an aspect, right, that brings the nature of choice in this pandemic scenario, right? In that case, right, what have we seen is like the VDI has been there. It's no new technology. If you look at today on-premise, it's there. But what has happened is like companies no longer can access it due to disruption because they cannot visit their offices due to this work from home strategy, right? And also the scalability aspect and all those things which Makar spoke about it, right? So it's quite important to understand like how VDI on the cloud, rather cloud native VDI, can help you in this journey. So, and also from there, two critical things to understand, like what is the end user requirement, right? And also from the how IT can flexibly and easily manage the entire SOAR for you, right? So seeing these scenarios, we categorize, as Makar highlighted, right, three buckets. The first and foremost is the app streaming space, where we see like the lightweight end users typically want the access to app, might be Office Outlook apps, or might be Excel or Google Sheets, or might be some lightweight ERP app, right? Without needing a complete virtual environment. So, and again, it's a fully managed service. They can get it through the browser window, a browser of a choice. Normally, Google Chrome works best, but you can use any of the browser you want. The second piece is we have seen a scenario where a lot of the teams, right? They require their dedicated environment as a virtual desktop. So typically, if you look at, you have a finance team, the legal team, or the marketing team, they have their own ways of software which has been customized and custom baked in for their usage, right? So in that case, they need the virtual desktop environment. And or even the IT folks, right, the developers and the QA teams, they need to run their own development environment or the QA teams for testing, right? In that sense, they need their environment. So in that case, you need a desktop as a service. In that case, it's again a fully managed environment which Google Cloud along with the partners can help you in this journey. And in that case, it can be a dedicated environment, like one user can have full access to the virtual environment, or it can be multi-session as well. And the third piece is the platform as a service. Google also gives you flexibility with the state of art technology using Kubernetes. I believe most of you guys are aware. You can even use Kubernetes to expose the VDI environment to end users. So these are on the high level three buckets where you can pick and choose depending upon the end user requirement and how flexible is IT or how comfortable the IT can manage the SOAP for you. So typically, then this guys, you need a DevOps guy or typically a Kubernetes engineer who can understand before he can do that containerization and expose the VDI. In this case, like app streaming and desktop as a service, you, Google along with its technology partners, along with our service integration partners like NetMagic can help you on this journey. So we at Google definitely love decision trees because this helps us to make the decisions very quick and spontaneous, right? So something like flowchart, if you have all used, right, in our life some point of the time, right? So if you need an application and if you need a containerized version of application and the application is ready enough to be exposed as that in a container platform and managed by Kubernetes, yes, we give you something using managed Kubernetes and we use a open source popular protocol, if you have heard of it, called WebRTC. It stands for Web Real-Time Communication and it is supported by the likes of Google and Apple and many other vendors. And in this case, what we do is like we expose containers and on top of that, it can serve you virtual desktops, the browser-based access, the app streaming, and for both audio, video, and the data as well. And if your workload cannot be containerized and you're looking to expose them as a VDI infrastructure, in that case, we have our partner solutions. We will cover this part of this session, Itopia and Citrix, which are very popular known here. Or if you need an entire desktop and you don't want to manage it, right? You need a fully managed service, as Makar was saying, right? To make the life of IT people easy and they can get started quickly, the speed of deployment, right? In this case, you can have Itopia and Citrix as well. Or if you want to manage your own environment. So we are also flexible in terms of Google as well, where we have our Kubernetes with WebRTC or even TerraDC, right? They have their own protocol, which is called PC over IP, right? So the idea here is, the key takeaway from this slide is, Google platform is quite flexible enough to accommodate your requirement. Wherever you are part of this journey in adopting VDI, we are there with our partners to help you. So the first technology vendor we are trying to cover is Itopia. So Google and Itopia jointly invested a lot amount of time and significant time to address this requirement for work from home, wherein Itopia stands out as a software as a service offering. And what it brings to the table as a value is you can quickly orchestrate and deploy the legacy Microsoft remote desktop services. And this remote desktop services are the same technology which have been you deploying it manually traditionally in your on-premise data centers. And what Itopia brings to the table, it orchestrates and automates the deployment of this complex activity so that your L1 engineers can easily manage this so without having detailed knowledge of RDS platform. So that's one aspect of it. And Itopia is more of a cloud automation software. It delivers, manages, monitors the entire deployment on the Google platform. So on a high level, so there are three components to it. So you have a Google Cloud platform, which offers you the infrastructure, basically the virtual machines. You have Microsoft legacy technologies, remote desktop services, and you have Itopia, which is basically a cloud automation layer, or think of it as a wrapper on top of RDS to ease your life. So as a result, you don't need to have to be a VDI expert or not even the Google Cloud platform architect as well, if you are new to Google. So you can get started with a short learning curve and get ready with your VDI infrastructure. So what Itopia brings in along with Google Cloud, and Itopia is exclusively on the Google Cloud, the region of choice of Google Cloud, as you know, right? Google is only one of the cloud service provider who owns the managed network. As a result, so what happens is it gives you faster speed, and from each data center are connected with transoceanic cables owned by Google. Once the data enters the Google Cloud, it's least exposed to the internet, so it becomes less vulnerable. On top of that, by default, everything in Google is encrypted. So encryption is no longer a choice. It's a best practice standard from Google. And the third and foremost piece is we at Google adheres, and Itopia also adheres on top of that, to all the industry leading certification and compliances you need, whether it is ISO or whether it is HIPAA, whether PCI DSS or FedRAMP or GDPR, you name it, your standard, we can help you in the journey adopting Itopia as a VDI platform on Google Cloud. So we talk about Itopia as an orchestration and automation layer to ease the life of the sysadmin, right? So if you look at this architecture level, I will not be covering in depth. So what Itopia brings in place, once you go to Google Cloud Marketplace, Marketplace, think of it as, if you're using cloud, you already know what Marketplace is. Marketplace is, if you're new to cloud, then Marketplace, think of it as iTunes of your apps or even the Play Store for the Android platform. So you go to Google Cloud Marketplace, subscribe to Itopia Cloud Automation Software, and then deploy it. So once you click deploy, what happens is all the magic happens beyond the under the hood. So what happens? The first step, it deploys all the infrastructure component right from the firewall rules, your private cloud network, load balancers, and then typically, again, this as a second step, it deploys the Active Directory, right? You want to retain the same user policies and on the same roles and privileges we have been using it. You don't want to change it. There are different ways to do it. Either you can use Google Cloud Platform Managed Service, or even on the infrastructure, or even extend those same policies by replicating. And on top of that, it also installs or deploys rather the Itopia deploys RDS software. So it has got multiple components, RDS, or rather roles, as Microsoft calls it, right? And you can also have file servers, and the choice is again yours. We can also use NetApp Cloud Volumes. These are typically used for storing your profiles and your data and all those stuffs. So if you look at, the heavy lifting is done by Itopia. The entire stack in the Google Cloud Platform, Itopia does it for you. So as a result, you don't need to be a certified Google Cloud Architect or a Cloud Engineer to do it. With the basic knowledge, the Itopia management can be done on GCP very quickly. On top of that, we spoke about the cloud automation layer, right, from Itopia, which is basically a wrapper around this entire RDS piece, right, which you see. So it does a lot of admin activities like managing your virtual machines, the user management, your policies, the security groups, and even it gives you insight using leveraging our serverless enterprise data warehouse offering called BigQuery, wherein you get detailed analysis, how your resource being used, how to optimize the cost on the GCP infra layer, and how the file is being accessed, what are the timings the users are getting connected. So it gives you a complete flexibility. Although it's a SaaS model, you have the control over the SaaS with optimization of infra on the Google Cloud Platform. So if you feel over a period of a time, Google Cloud gives you a console window wherein you can see the recommendation saying that, okay, you can undersize it because the utilization is less for this particular virtual environment, or you need to increase it, scale it up depending on the requirement. So the platform is entirely flexible and Itopia completely leverages it. So here it how it looks like. You have a user. He might be connected from any device, might be corporate device, might be home device like BYOD. Typically, we use these days in this pandemic scenario. We get connected to the Google Cloud Platform where the RDS software, your applications are hosted. And as you see, so the user get two choices. Either he can have a complete desktop environment to give a better desktop end user experience, seamless experience, or he can have an app. So you don't have to think of two different offerings. Typically, if you've looked at a competition, right, whether on cloud or on-premise, you might have end up buying two different products if you want app streaming or you want a virtual desktop. But with Itopia, it's just a single stack, single offering, catering to two different requirements for the end user. So again, this is how your environment might look like. You might have Adobe Photoshop, Excel, or Google Sheet, or even the accounting ERP, which are the lightweight, which can be streamed through your browser window instead of logging into the entire desktop. So we spoke about something called the low cost, right, which Itopia and Google Cloud can help you in this journey. And the second thing, the speed of deployment. So we'll see a use case where Itopia really did a speed of deployment. We can quantify that. The third piece, which I'd like to highlight, is the ease of management. So if you look at this console, this is the Itopia console. You don't have to even go to the Google console to manage the virtual machines, firewall rules, the complex activity, not required. Your L1 sysadmin can manage entire show for you. Directly spinning up the virtual machines, it can optimize the uptime. Let's say, for instance, your working hour is 9 to 6, sometimes 5 days a week or 6 days a week, whatever it is time. You can define a schedule so that after the working time, you can shut down. Even you can define an exception, something like dynamic uptime. So what happens is sometimes some users are required to work over the weekend to support production issues, might be from a support guy. You can define all those things. You can also build in the resiliency using snapshot mechanism so that you can recover if something goes wrong. And also, let's say, for example, so what happens is, you cannot migrate your application, but you still want a VDI environment, right? In that case, you can expose your the clients in the virtual environment through Itopia software, and then they can access through a VPN and then enter your data center network. So you can also do the VPN management right from here. And of course, the insights, as we spoke in the previous slide, right? It uses the state-of-art technology, serverless mechanism, BigQuery, wherein you can get all the details and we are granular level right from the GCP infra cost to the level of usage of user. So the best part is you can define everything right in one console without switching back to the GCP console. So it gives a seamless experience even for the IT admins who are new to the VDI. So one other aspect Itopia brings to the table is, so sometimes what happens is we have seen like the end users, even if they need a virtual desktop, it can be handled through a multi-session environment instead of a dedicated environment. So Itopia can give you both of those so that you can optimize and you know, in cloud, right? Everything you over-provision is a penalty, right? It's not like on-premise traditional way of doing things. So you need to optimize the cost. So as with Itopia, with a multi-session environment, and each session is isolated from other session so that they don't intervene or don't eat away resources as such. So Itopia gives you that flexibility. And plus, we spoke about Itopia can give you both, either app streaming or fully virtual desktop. The choice is yours depending on that. And what Itopia leverages is Google's flexible per second billing, which is unique to Google. We started this and we have been a pioneer in this journey with per second billing. And plus the custom VM saves, right? Sometimes you happen is like either you require a save, because of the nature of the cloud vendor, you get locked down with the predefined save, right? As a result, you over-provision it. As I said, anything you over-provision is a penalty in cloud, or you under-provision it, then you get a performance hit, right? With custom saves, what you bring to the table for the customer is they can choose the save of choice and configuration they want, particular the core count or the RAM count, anything which adheres to their application requirement, it can be done very well with GCP. So one good use case we saw in this pandemic scenario, it's a real-time use case. TELUS is a leading brand, international brand, as a part of TELUS telecommunication unit in Canada. So they adhere to the customer experience service providing and they help all the leading global brands. So most of the time, if you call the call center service of any leading global brand, you might have end up calling the TELUS International. That's the unit which provides customer service. So what happened was due to pandemic scenario, their frontline workers ranging around 2,500 to 3,000 could not go to office as we are supposed to quarantine in home, right? So as a result, the business was disrupted, right? So what happened Itopia did was they helped this, deployed this for 2,500 virtual desktops environment in the cloud with GCP in just a matter of 24 hours. So they can seamlessly and securely connect to their on-premise data center applications, wherein they can access their apps, typically voice apps and audio apps and chat messages, right, to service the requirement without even migrating the complex applications to cloud. So this was the use case and they get started in the next business day. So again, so looking forward to the Itopia, so it's completely a SaaS platform. Depends on the data center you want to deploy. You have the control over the SaaS platform, want to deploy in Mumbai, want to deploy in Singapore, somewhere in Europe, you can do that a multi-region deployment. And we said like you don't need a separate solution for like app streaming or for entire Windows virtual desktop. You can get both the offerings in a single bundle with Itopia on GCP and the automation, right? This is the key crux because it automates not only the GCP infrastructure, but also lot of installing the RDS component and building the sync up with Active Directory and all those things. And the simplicity, ease of management, we saw in that, right? You can the IT admins like L1 admins can easily manage this show from Itopia console. And of course, the cost effectiveness, right? It has got a bunch of features like auto scaling, which does directly from the cloud Itopia console, and also the custom saves, the dynamic uptime, and all those things are bundled in, and it has got 300 such automation tasks out of the box to help you to optimize the cost. And of course, the security piece we spoke about, right? Everything in Google is encrypted by default. Itopia adheres to it. And on top of that, of course, the compliance and standards it follows, which Google provides. So if you have a requirement, Itopia was one of the vendor we have tied up, but we also have a tie up with Citrix. So this journey is not new. We started with Citrix in 2011, where we incorporated the Citrix workspace, which is very popular, right? And Citrix has been the leader in this journey of something digital workspace, networking, and analytics, right? So we teamed up with them in 2011, where they incorporated in Chromebooks and Google devices. If you're aware, there are these offerings. So saying this, we started this journey. And again, when Google Cloud started, so we thought to incorporate those Citrix type of enterprise VDI on Google Cloud. So typically, why Citrix chose us? Because the reliability and security and trust, because of our network backbone, which we own, the encryption and a lot of security standards, the compliances, and the serverless approach of the building in the insights with BigQuery, and of course, the collaboration tool which we give, right, for productivity and workforce, G Suite, Hangout, Drive, and all those things. So one thing we did with Citrix was to ease the management, because Citrix requires some sort of knowledge and the expertise to manage, unlike Itopia. But Citrix, what brings it to the plate, right? They started a Citrix Cloud where you can transfer the control plane to Citrix. It manages the complexity. And in Google Cloud, you deploy your environment and get started. And you can, again, go to GCP Marketplace, search for Citrix, NetScaler, or ADC. That's the component you need to get started with the Google. And again, you get a unified control management with your Citrix console and Google. And again, it utilizes on-demand pricing model, which Google offers you. No commitment, no upfront payment. And auto-scaling is rightly built. If you're using VDI or non-VDI as well, auto-scaling is there. And the right sizing recommendation, which comes with machine learning expertise, which Google has been a pioneer in this space. And you get instant access to the VDI environment with Citrix once you get started on GCP. And if you want to get started with the POC, and it is also very fast. It's not like a traditional way where you have to install all the components like storefront. And if you have an MCS, machine catalog, a lot of components goes with Citrix, right? But with Citrix Cloud and Google Cloud coming together, it makes the journey easier. So with this, I will show you a brief demo, how it looks like. So if you look at, this is the web browser with Itopia, you get it. And you can just go and start using it as if you have this browser end user. But if you need a full-fledged virtual desktop, you can go to this link and download it, and you can get started with the RDP client. And once you get started, you just need to log in to the user, and you get an entire virtual desktop environment. So again, the choice is yours. Whatever the way you want, you can get started. You get a full virtual desktop environment with a multi-session or a dedicated environment, or you basically need an app streaming. So here you go. If you can see my screen, you get a virtual environment desktop. And in the prior screen, we saw it was primarily your app streaming mechanism. So you can get started. So over to you, Mantis. Thanks for the opportunity to speak on this webinar.
Thank you, Pritham. Audience, please send in your queries on chat. Now, we'll be taking our second poll on how coronavirus has impacted your business. While everybody is taking the second poll, I would now like to invite Makar again to take us through a few more entity NetMagic proposition for the enterprises. Over to you, Makar.
Okay, thank you, Mantesh. Yep. Okay. Okay. Before I answer that, I just would like to share some facts with the participant. Okay, for previous poll question. Okay, and I saw that literally 60% of the answers are. They are either not prepared or somewhat prepared or unprepared. And I saw somewhere between 30 to 35% says that they are prepared for the pandemic. So if we see our businesses for the 60% okay answers or the people who is working the respective organizations, it is 60%. We can straightforward say that organizations are still not really and fully prepared for this pandemic, and we need to rethink on how we can ensure that during this pandemic our business continuity is ensured, and can we leverage the technologies like VDI to enable the employees to work from home. So that was an interesting fact, actually. I'm coming back to Mahantesh's question. Entity Net Magic, okay. Entity Net Magic is started in 1998 with internet and data center services in India.
Makar, you need to share your slides, I believe.
Okay, shall I share? Oh, yeah, yeah. 1 second. Thank you for that. Can you see my screen?
Yeah, okay.
Thank you. So yeah, an entity, as I mentioned, Entity Net, actually the Net Magic started in 1998 with internet services and data center business in India, when there was hardly a few players around there, and that too again a restricted or government companies. Subsequently, in 2012, Entity Global group has acquired the Net Magic, and now Entity Net Magic or Net Magic is a part of 107 billion Entity Global group. Okay, and by bringing the Entity family together, now the Net Magic is positioned than ever, okay, to make the differences. The major portfolio or the product offering from Entity Net Magic is colo services. Then we have a play in cloud businesses, internet, cloud managed services offering, security offering, network services offering. So if you have any IT requirement, Entity Net Magic have a solution, and they're there to help you. With the Google, Entity Net Magic is a premier partner, okay, now for both Google cloud platform as well as the G Suite offering, okay. And for Google Cloud Platform, again, all the major use cases, like it can be a SAP, it can be a databases, or all the features or all the capabilities which are available under the Google Cloud Platform, Net Magic have a right skill set at place, okay. And then to support all the managed services app aspect, billing aspect, right away from designing your cloud solution that includes a standard cloud workloads, that includes the VDI deployments, that includes the collaboration tools requirement, like we need a Hangout to do a collaboration calls, or we need to do, we need some platform like Google Sheets where we can share the content across all the team members, they can access it, and everything is secured. So with Net Magic, okay, with Google Cloud, Net Magic, as I mentioned, a premier partner, and we are helping customers, okay, right away from their designing architecture, build and migrate, and that includes a managed services option as well. On top of that, Net Magic is also providing other services, like it can be a security, it can be a colo, managed hosting, and other options as well. But I'm restricting my answer to this, where how the Net Magic is helping customers to respond or to ensure that the business continuity is ensured during this pandemic time. As I mentioned, like Entity Net Magic is coming from a decades of experience since the first actual data center, okay, started in India. And over the time, we have leveraged, or we have like introduced so many products that meets your requirement. We have a comprehensive service suite, okay, for your end-to-end solutions that can include a colo, private, public cloud, container, migration, or all the cloud requirement around the Google Cloud, as well as other requirement, Entity Net Magic is helping you. We have a uniquely positioned a team which serves the enterprise and a global client in 24/7 environment. Even during this pandemic, Net Magic's team is up working live, and all our customer services are up and running. There is no impact on the customers even during this pandemic for the Entity Net Magic services, okay, thanks to the staff, and we call them as a heroes, actually, who is working to ensure that the businesses are continued and there is no any interrupt on the customer services, actually. So this is how the Entity Net Magic is proposing a value to the customer. If I see a customer, what they're really getting is the Entity Net Magic is also helping the consulting, like how to design the cloud solution and ensure that the TCO or the total cost of ownership is optimal. The technology has to be future proof actual. And then we do help customer to custom the solutions or tailored solutions actually, which fits for the requirement. And then on top of that, the robust infrastructure in terms of monitoring and management. as a trusted partner who is closely working with the Google Cloud and VDI, which is provided by the Itopia team. So this is how Entity NetMagic is helping you. Thank you, Mandesh, for that question.
Okay. Thank you, Makar. We will now take up audience questions. The first question is from Muthu Krishnan G, and he says, what is the bandwidth required for a single VDI for remote users?
Yeah, this is a great question, and especially when the country like us, where most of users are using a mobility. In fact, right now I'm using one of the carrier. Okay, so if we see the POC results of Itopia, okay, who is actual a software as a service vendor for VDI solution, and what they say for optimal performance for the remote desktop, 150 kbps bandwidth per user should be sufficient. And on top of that, even though if user have a minimum like 150 kbps with stable latency, no jitter on the link, then also user should be able to access the desktop. Okay, and again, we need a remote RDP client as well on top of that. So if you ask me, a very minimal bandwidth, 250 kb is easily what we get actually in these days. I agree that the higher bandwidth, like if we are doing a HD video call where we need 3.2 mbps kind of minimum bandwidth, but for the VDI, for this environment, it's a very minimal which is 250 kbps bandwidth is needed. And if you ask me the latency, I think even up to 100 or 150 millisecond latency performance should be optimal.
Okay.
I would like to add on that. So thanks, Makar, for calling it out. So I would like to highlight my experience. Like I have seen like 100 to 150 kbps works well. Plus, again, for the, if you have a GPU-based workload, right? And it again helps on those environment as well. So that's perfectly fine as long as you have without jitter anything. So again, it all depends how much bandwidth can accommodate, but 100 to 150 kbps should be fine.
Okay. Thank you, Preetam. There is a related question from Abdul Rafi. Can we connect Office PC through RDP from iOS or Android tabs or phones?
Yeah, so here it comes is this Citrix, the workspace, right? We spoke about on the higher level, right? So Citrix has that solution. Yes, it can do any endpoint management devices. You can do that as long as your work can be done through a mobile handheld devices. So nothing stops to you. But for Itopia, it's primarily the terminals or the desktops or the laptops or the PCs, what you see. So yes, it can be handled through Citrix.
Okay. Thank you, Preetam. Next question is from Jigar. This is for Makar. In case of complete desktop VDI, at the time of desktop restart reboot, does the data stored on the desktop get saved or data is lost? Is no, the data in case stored of centrally or individually on the system? That's a related second question.
Yes. Okay, I will answer both. Okay, the VDI solution what we are proposing with Itopia, in order to ensure, okay, now the employees are bringing their own desktop or devices. Okay, knowing all those security and data related issue concerns, user data or the application data never gets stored in the device. All the data is stored right away inside the Google Cloud. And when I say inside the Google Cloud, then security is ensured actually by default.
And also to highlight what Makar said, it all depends on the how much lockdown environment you need, right? So what happens typically is sometimes you don't allow your local BYOD laptop to connect it through a USB wherein they can connect to or download something from the remote desktops, right? Or even the print screens, right? Or even the printers to allow or to take a print. So all those things can be defined as a policy, as Makar clearly highlighted. So so you can have a lockdown environment to have to secure a sensitive or private data in the VDI environment.
Okay. Thank you, Preetam. The next question is, what is the encryption method used for data in transit scenario? This is from Dharmaraj Ramakrishna.
Okay. So so you use TLS on HTTP. So that's there. Let me take, for example, for the Itopia, right? So it by default with Google or even with Itopia or as a VDI on Google, it uses the TLS transcription, HTTPS. And then what happens is there are some components we spoke about in the architecture, right? The remote desktop gateways, right? That converts and decrypts that into 33 port 89, and then transfers the user connection to the virtual desktop environment. So it's always encrypted on the transit as well as at rest in Google Cloud.
Yep. And in okay. Continue to Pritam's question, okay, the exact or the more precise answer, if it's a protocol, then all the TSL protocol like transport layer security protocols, Google support by default, okay, it can be a TSL 1.0 to SSL 3.0, or if it's about the signing keys, even they do use actual 2048 kind of RSA actual or even a P256 kind of SSL certificates, which are highly secure actual. If it's they do use AES 128 as well. If it's a ciphering suit, then you name it. I think they have more than 5 different cipher suits supported. Okay, it can be ECDHE, or it can be RSA with AES, or it can be RSA with 3DES, or it can be RSA with RC4. For signing, they have a different actual RSA 2048, as I mentioned. They do support hash functions like MD5. So I think security is in Google's DNA, because they are the one who faces millions of attacks in a day. And that's from actual the strong security background they are coming, and they do have a strong security culture actually, as by default actually.
Okay. Thank you, Makar. Thanks for explaining in detail. There is a next question from Sunil Tripathi. Basically, Pritam talked about Citrix VDI and Itopia. He wants to know, what is the main difference between Citrix VDI and Itopia?
Yeah, so this is a very valid ask. I was expecting this question as well. So it depends. Like, if you are exposing the end user environment as a Windows-based environment. So what I mean is Windows-based, I mean by Windows desktop experience. Itopia is the platform of, should be a platform of choice. Or if you have a mixed workload like Windows per Linux, right? Sometimes what happens is, like, you have the IT teams, right? They do a lot of activity on the Linux environment as a virtual desktop, right? In that case, Citrix play a major role. So the use case, you need to define where you want to go. But saying this, if you have a Windows, Itopia should be the first choice. That's my personal experience with Itopia. And as well as Citrix, the reason, because the ease of use we spoke about, right? The ease of management, apart from low cost and the speed of deployment. We talked about Telus International, right? The customer where they deployed around 2,500 VMs in just 24 hours, and the learning curve is quite fast. But if you look at Citrix, it should be used when it has got your Linux plus Windows workload, or typically a Linux workload, which is exposed as to the end users.
Okay. The next question is from Dharmaraj again. He wants to know, what's the lead time for overall assessment and implementation of VDI solutions?
Okay. So if you look at with this Itopia, I can tell you, because I have been part of this as well as Makar, we worked on an opportunity, right? So if you look at the POC cycle is less. Because customer wants to get a flavor, right? We define the success criteria, 2-3 criteria, 5 criteria, whatever it is. And within a week, you are done with the POC and the deployment, as I said, with the Telus International, right? It's a global use case. You can find it on GCP as well as on Itopia website. They deployed around 2,500 virtual environments for 2,500 employees in 24 hours. So you can see the speed of deployment. You can get ready within 24 hours. And that's the scale and massiveness in Itopia offers. But with Citrix, you need some expertise to handle, because Citrix has been there a leader in this space for the enterprise VDI, but that lead time is slightly higher than Itopia.
Okay.
Yep. Yeah. And in continuation to Pritam, I would like to add something here.
Makar, go ahead. Please, go ahead.
Shall I? Okay. Thank you. Okay. So team, actual entity NetMagic and Google. Yep. Okay. So entity NetMagic. Okay. And the Google is working for VDI solution for one of the customer in India, where we are going to spin up a VDI environment for 100K users, 1 lakh. Can you believe that kind of a massive actual the capacity is supported, and the overall deployment will not take actual more than a few days, hardly 3 or 4 days to set up that kind of massive VDI environment actual. So we have done a successful POC with most stringent criterias with the client, okay, and as minimum as even we are able to support like 10 or 15 VDI kind of requirement, and it can be many thousands as well. In terms of timeline, it will hardly change 1 or 2 days for VDI kind of deployment. That's how it is automated. Itopia team has literally enabled 300 common tasks actually, which is there needed to set up the VDI environment. So if you see, what we claim is 98% of your requirement is automated, and what we need is just to press the button and enable that specific configuration which is needed for your setup. So that's how it is. Thank you, Mantesh.
Okay. Thanks, Makar. In the current context, VDI seems to be very relevant. There is a question from Melvin. He wants to know, what is the future of VDI post-COVID situation? And will there be a replacement for this technology or anything else that's coming up?
Okay. Can I take this up, or you'd like Makar to take this up?
Please, any one of you. Or if you can add on to each other's response.
Ritam, go ahead.
Thanks, Makar. I'll
be happy to get both your perspectives.
Yeah. See, so previously work from home was considered privileged, right? We all know that in the Indian context, right? So, but now even the COVID goes out, we all know this uncertain times is going to come, like something like Spanish flu came in early 1900, right? Now it is COVID-19. So it is going to there to stay, because there is uncertain time. And so work from home might not be complete 100%, but there will be some resources who are frontline workers, right? Where they still use desktops and because they have sensitive data in their office, they cannot carry to their home, whatever the reasons, regulatory reasons and constraints they have, right? In that case, I believe 40 to 50% workforce will be there going forward. And this is my gut feeling, although I don't have a numbers to quantify that, but I believe the industry will head towards that because the new norm has arrived. It's no longer a new norm now. It is now a part and parcel of life, as cloud was a new norm few years back. And cloud is now a part and parcel of life. So I would like to put it that way.
Okay, great. Thank you, Pritham. And then there is something, some other. Yeah, yes. So now the other funny portion. Okay, like we saw that if we see the India's technological history or the technology evolutions, we are falling behind from the rest of the countries like Europe and US, like a 2G, 3G or 4G kind of technology. Then software technology has come, and now we are equally competing with the globe as well. Okay, but if we see the way Europe and US guys have that work from home culture is a default, or for them it's not a new normal. But if we talk about the India, we say the work from home is new normal for us. So I think going forward, even India will be in equally sizing with the Europe or Americans when it comes to the work from home kind of culture. And I don't think it is okay going after this pandemic. It is remained to be in Indian DNA as well, and we are going to work like how the Europe and American works, and the work from home is one of their default strategy for their employees actually. And I don't see, as Pritham has mentioned, that VDI is going away or some other technology is replacing it, because if you see most of the hyperscalers, that including a Google Cloud as well, the VDI is a prominent, and which is really helping the businesses to continue to the run literally from the anywhere, any place, and that is for long term. So this is not a short term solution. We need to think for a long term, like 5 years, 8 years kind of a strategy. So that is my opinion. Thank you
Makar and Pritham for your insights, and I think audience would have gained a lot from your perspective. To quickly recap, remote working is here to stay. If not all, at least part of the workforce, as enterprises are realizing its value. Even in a scenario where we totally vanquish the virus, it would make sense to continue with remote working as a buffer against any future disruptions. To make workplaces more equitable and inclusive, and because this COVID very well be future of work, we have been talking about. desktop as a service then is a necessity to seek from disruption to the future of work. I'm sure all our audience today who are present have found valuable insights to take from this webinar. With that, we have come to the end of this webinar. Thank you for attending this webinar. I hope you found it interesting and informative. Do remember to complete the feedback form that will be emailed to you. Everyone who sends in the completed feedback form will receive access to Google Meet subscription valid till 30th September 2020 and loading self course from Harappa Education. Thank you, everyone. Goodbye. Look forward to connect with you all soon. Thanks again.
Thank you, everyone.
Thank you, team. Thank you for taking your time.